In this video, we're computing the vertical deflection of a beam of alpha particles shot through a region of uniform electric field between two parallel plates. Now, alpha particles, which is actually the same thing as a helium nucleus, consist of two protons and two neutrons, giving them a charge of plus twice the elementary charge, 2qE. So our approximate charge on these particles is 3.2 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. We're given the approximate mass of the alpha particle as 6.64 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. And we're told the particles in this beam have a speed of 2 times 10 to the 6th meters per second. The strength of the electric field, 10 to the 5th newtons per coulomb. And what we're after here is the vertical deflection distance, delta y, as these particles pass through the 12 centimeter horizontal length between these plates. Now, before we get started, I want to address just the big idea here. The electric force is given by a Q times E in its magnitude, and it points down because I have positive particles feeling a force in the same direction as the electric field. So this is why the beam is deflected. Our particles feel a downward force as they pass between these plates. The second point I want to bring up before we start actually grinding through any equations is that the force of gravity is negligible in this problem. Gravity is very weak compared to electric forces, and when I ran the numbers comparing the electric force to the gravitational force in this example, gravity was actually weaker by 12 orders of magnitude, so absolutely negligible. Now, the motion that results from this vertical electric force is actually exactly the same thing as projectile motion. This is exerting a force only in the y direction, so we have a y acceleration in the problem, and there are no forces in the x direction, so the x velocity is going to be constant. That's the same thing as projectile motion. So in part A, we're asked to compute the time for the particle to pass through the plates. And the key to this is to realize there's no acceleration in the x direction, so we can write down the equation of motion for the x coordinate of the particles. And that's x equals x naught plus v naught x t. There's no acceleration term on that, again, because there's no forces acting horizontally. Now, another way to write this is to subtract the x naught from both sides, and x minus x naught is just a change in x. So I'm going to write delta x is v naught x times t. And that's basically just saying distance equals rate times time in that x coordinate direction. Well, to find the time it takes to pass through the plates, I just have to take that horizontal displacement, delta x, and divide by the x velocity of the particles. And that x velocity of the particles, which is the same as the initial x velocity of the particles because it never changes, that's 2 times 10 to the 6 meters per second that was given to us. So my delta x is 12 centimeters or 0.12 meters. My velocity in the x direction throughout this entire process is 2 times 10 to the 6th meters per second. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 6.00 times 10 to the negative 8th seconds. Now in part B, we're asked to actually get the vertical deflection delta y, which is the main goal of the problem. So this time we're going to do an analysis of the y coordinate of the motion. So I can write y equals y naught plus v naught yt plus 1/2 ay t squared. And there's a couple things to clean up here. Y minus y naught is delta y. So I'm going to write delta y on the left-hand side. And the second thing I want to clean up is that v naught y is equal to zero. There is no initial vertical y velocity. That beam entered horizontally between these plates. So that term vanishes, and I just get delta y is 1/2 times my y acceleration times the time for the process squared. Now, we got the time for the process in part A, but what about that y acceleration? That's the result of the vertical electric force forcing this beam downward. To get that y acceleration, we have to use Newton's second law. So I'm going to write Ay is Fy over m for these particles. The y force is the electric force, Q times E, and the mass is the mass of an alpha particle, so I'll call that m alpha. Plugging in the numbers here, we have a charge of 3.2 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs, an electric field strength of 10 to the 5th newtons per coulomb. So the units come out to newtons there in the numerator. And then the mass of our alpha particles, that's 6.64 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 4.82 times 10 to the 12th meters per second squared. Now we can go back to our calculation of the vertical deflection, delta y, and we can plug in that acceleration. And because that acceleration points downward, it's most correct to keep a minus sign on that. But really, I think the usual interpretation of this problem would be, what's the magnitude of that deflection delta y? So I'm not going to write the minus sign in this. So we plug in that acceleration, 4.82 times 10 to the 12th meters per second squared, multiplied by the time for the process, which was 6 times 10 to the negative 8th all squared. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 0.00867 meters. That's nicer if we express it in millimeters as 8.67 millimeters. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.